the traditional realizing the American dream, a bunch of Europeans coming here in the 18th century to find the American dream. This guy came 200 years later from a different part of the world. He takes the 20th century version of most of our roots.
We always remember that time when Akeem pulled up in the cab and he says, hello, man, I'm looking for Coach Guy Lewis. He said, well, he's at the school. And all of us are laughing. It's like, well, who is that?
Abdul-Olajuwon from Lagos, Nigeria.
This may be the nation's finest athlete in terms of basketball.
I pulled up for a shot from the top of the key and took a shot, and he was standing about at the dotted line and jumped up and caught it. And he goes, oh, here's your shot.
Oh, where did he come from?
If there's a Horatio Alger, there certainly has to be a Hakeem Olajuwon, because his story is even one that's better to tell.
Never in the history of doing games for the Houston Rockets ever seen a greater performance than Hakeem Olajuwon.
You'd have to think about this. If you wanted to shoot a movie of a guy like Hakeem coming over here and seeing his progress, nobody would believe it. They'd say that. No way that could happen. But it did happen.
Hakeem's long journey began in Lagos, Nigeria, where to make his story even more incredible, he grew up playing every sport except basketball.
High jump, team handball, field hockey. And I was more of an all-around athlete where I just like to play.
But standing 6 feet 7 inches tall at the age of 16, Hakeem finally discovered the sport he seemed destined for.
Basketball has something that's so unique that immediately I pick up the game and, you know, realize that this is the sport for me. All the other sports just becomes a secondary.
Learning the game at an incredible pace, he led his high school to a national championship. And at the age of 18, now standing almost 6 feet 10 inches tall, Hakeem would be urged by his coach to continue his development in America.
My first response is, I didn't know anybody in the United States. Then he told me he has some friends which are coaches in the United States. And we talked to Coach Lewis.
This guy says, Coach, I said, yeah. He said, this is Akeem. And he said, I want to come down to Houston. And of course, he told me he was about 6'7" or 8", and I immediately figured that'd be 6'4" or 5". And I said, well, come on down. I went in and see my two assistants and said, we got this guy coming in from Africa that wants somebody to meet him at the airport.
I said, well, you want me to run out to the airport and pick him up? When is he coming in? He said, probably about 11:30, 12 o'clock. I said, well, Coach, I'll go out there. He says, no. He says, let him take a cab. It was about 12:30, 1 o'clock, and here comes a cab. And there's Akeem getting out of the car, getting out of the yellow cab, and getting out of the yellow cab, and getting out of the yellow cab. The kid was so big, Guy V says, Donnie, get out there and get that kid's bag and get him in this office.
Hakeem had entered a strange new world, but he quickly set about making himself at home.
The campus life was a wonderful life for me. Getting to meet people, different students from different majors, different backgrounds. Getting up in the morning, going to class. So I'm on campus, you know, I'm a university student.
Hakeem's adjustment on the court went equally well. Though his offensive skills were limited, he made his impact felt from the start.
Block by Olajuwon, what a play by Olajuwon.
Improving with every game, Hakeem helped the Cougars go all the way to the Final Four. And though they would lose to the eventual champion, the North Carolina Tar Heels, Hakeem's basketball education was just beginning.
I told him that. I said, you just need to work hard this summer on your shooting and offensive ability. And there's no doubt you'll be a starter next year. And of course, boy, he just lit up at that.
Working out during the offseason in a Houston recreation center, Hakeem found a perfect opponent to help him in the next stage of his development.
That summer, we were playing with the professionals. You know, that's where I was playing against Moses Malone. Moses was not, you know, really playing around. He was very physical and really playing me very tough.
Moses really took it to him. He pounded on him, he banged on him. And I know there were days, Hakeem has said, that he wanted to stop. He wanted to quit, but he also had a drive to be the best, and Moses brought that out of him.
After months of daily battles, Hakeem sent his mentor a final message that he had learned his lessons well.
A shot was taken, and Hakeem came out of nowhere, and he went up and he grabbed it. And he went back up, and Moses, you know, went up with him. And we're just going to say, oh, Lord, he's going to throw the young boy down. And Hakeem just took Moses and just like threw him down and dunked it. And we all looked and said, oh, here we go.
Hakeem was now ready to test his hard-earned skills, and the Cougars' schedule promptly gave him the ideal opportunity.
We had this tournament every year. It's called the Bluebonnet Classic. And Sonny Smith brought his Auburn Tigers in, and Mr. Charles Barkley was with him. And he said the first thing he's going to do, he's going to dunk on Hakeem. First four times he went up to dunk it, Hakeem had four block shots.
And throughout his sophomore year, Hakeem would send notice to the college basketball world that he was now ready to dominate.
He hustles down the floor as well as any big man that's ever played the game. And Olajuwon, a one-man wrecking crew. Hartman, oh, at the free throw line. That's a no-no. This game's too easy. They bring a lot of Nigerians over with it.
His game progressed to the point where he was very good on both ends of the court. No longer was he a liability on the offensive end. And once he developed that, there's nothing you could do.
Olajuwon, any questions?
Behind Olajuwon, the Cougars reeled off 22 straight wins. Suddenly, Hakeem was at the center of basketball's best team and most celebrated fraternity.
Vice Lemma Gemma at its best.
It just took off. I mean, it nationwide, people started hearing about Vice Lemma Gemma. And the players took a lot of pride in that.
Juan Roseboro has it swatted away by Hakeem. I've got six blocks now for Olajuwon. Franklin back to Michael Young.
Houston would go on to win the Southwest Conference title and race through the early rounds of the NCAA tournament. And after defeating the celebrated Louisville Cardinals in the semifinals, they headed into the championship game as clear favorites to take home the national title.
Jordan rejected by the game. Olajuwon with six rejections. Yuck! What a show. And so the Houston Cougars have won now 26 in a row.
You know, you guys had 13 dunks today. I don't know if you realize that. Pretty good high percent. 13.
That's it? I think that's great. Louisville can't join our fraternity.
And they can, huh?
Since the semifinal was billed up as the best teams in college basketball, Louisville against Houston, after we won that game, we kind of thought, well, we're the best.
And as the game began, it seemed as if Hakeem and his Cougars would easily sweep the North Carolina State Wolfpack aside.
Hakeem is everywhere, isn't he? Olajuwon, 20 points. Can't say much more. He's making jumpers, blocking shots, grabbing rebounds.
But as time wound down, Houston made a fatal mistake.
We made our run. We built up the lead. Then we tried to secure that lead by spreading the court, which really worked against us.
The Cougars had given the Wolfpack a chance to get back into the game.
Wittenberg, he can tie it up. It's deadlock.
And with seconds remaining and the score tied, the national championship would be decided by one final play.
They've got a drive to the basket. It's down to 7 seconds. You can see the time. Wittenberg, oh, it's a long way. Kids, North Carolina State has captured their second NCAA championship, 54-52.
I was, you know, just disappointed because, you know, we were the better team, and we know that we were supposed to win, but we did not win.
Though Houston had fallen short, Hakeem's stock had never been higher, and speculation was rampant that he would follow his teammate Clyde Drexler into the NBA.
It was really touch and go that he was going to go. They were going to have a dual signing and everything else, and he just felt like that he wanted to try one more time to win it.
With most of the 83 Cougars team gone, Hakeem would now take Houston's fate into his own hands. In his junior year, he would be named an All-American. he would lead Houston to a school record 32 wins, and he would return to the NCAA Finals to battle for redemption against the Georgetown Hoyas and their great center, Patrick Ewing.
The NCAA championship game is about to begin, and Houston and its fans are confident that this is finally their championship season, and the Cougars have the force on their side.
As he had all season, Hakeem tried to single-handedly take over the game. But Georgetown's depth and talent would ultimately prove to be too much.
Pass, and Michael Graham took over from there.
It just came down to who had what around them. And unfortunately, Ewing had a lot more around him than Hakeem did.
And so, for the second straight year, Hakeem Abdul-Olajuwon has tasted bitter defeat in this final game.
His dreams of a championship had again been shattered, and once more he faced a difficult choice. This time, however, he would decide that his future was now.
Oh, yes, that's why I just want to end the speculation that's been going around. Maybe I'm going to stay or I'm going to go. So I want everybody to know I'm leaving this school this year.
The Houston Rockets select Hakeem Olajuwon of the University of Houston.
Hakeem Olajuwon, who started playing basketball just 5 years ago from Nigeria, is now the number one pick.
Being number one player pick in the old draft, that's a big accomplishment. And there's a lot of pressure. They're picking you over somebody like Michael Jordan. To say this would be a mistake of a lifetime. So you can't afford to say this is a mistake.
Hakeem would quickly show the Rockets that he was far from a mistake.
This is but Olajuwon with the big offensive follow. He's a force.
Chambers over Lloyd. Blocked by Olajuwon. Again by Olajuwon.
It was an awesome experience just watching some of the things that he can do on the court. You know, he's a combination of quickness and finesse combined with strength and power.
Makes a move left. Ah!
He would always get on you if you would foul before letting his man get to the basket so he could block a shot. He said, don't foul, I get the ball, man, I get the ball.
Teaming Hakeem with 7'4" Ralph Sampson, Houston now featured the celebrated Twin Towers, and together they terrorized the lead.
Olajuwon off to Ralph Sampson. He jams another one home.
And the Rockets are rolling.
It was fun because we started dunking on people also. I started having the same feel that I did in college.
Olajuwon slam dunk. How about a give and go between the Twin Towers?
When you got two guys that can run, because one of them is always down the other end of the court. And then when both of us get down there, I mean, it was a tough decision for the guards who to give it to, but it was a tough decision for the people that were defending us who they were going
to
guard.
Olajuwon. Olajuwon to Sampson, slam!
There were some games the players would say, oh man, why you got to embarrass me like that? Why you got to make me drive to the hole? Because it's like, yo, we wanted to see the two big guys play volleyball with your shot.
Even though they lost, we played bird.
In Hakeem's first 2 years, the Rockets would go from last place to a division crown.
Lucas, this is
a monster in Houston, Texas.
And in the 1985-86 season, they would storm into the playoffs.
The lights, the party's over.
They would breeze through the postseason's first two rounds.
Oh my!
And they would make it all the way to the Western Conference Finals, where they faced the defending champion Los Angeles Lakers. And though the inexperienced Rockets were underdogs, they were also undaunted.
How do you feel the Houston Rockets matchup against the LA Lakers?
Feel real good, because I'm sure we can beat them.
But as the series began in LA, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar used his vast playoff experience to teach Hakeem a painful playoff lesson.
Kareem, basket good. Kareem, inside against Olajuwon. He beat them both on that play. And the L.A. Lakers have taken a 1-0 lead in their best-of-seven Western Final, beating Hakeem and the Rockets.
No doubt about it, they're the world champs, and they were the better ball club today. If we don't play better, this thing will be over in a hurry.
Hakeem was determined that the Rockets would play better, and he personally ensured that they did.
Olajuwon blocks. Cooper back on defense against Level. Feeds Lloyd. Feeds Olajuwon. Ball into Kareem, turn to the right, puts it up, blocked by Olajuwon!
Magic closely guarded. Takes the ball into Kareem. It double team, they steal it. Lewis Lloyd, great defense. The ball cross-courted over to Reed. He comes underneath, blows it, slam dunk, and a rebound by Olajuwon. And the Lakers are being humbled, humiliated at home. The Los Angeles Lakers are beaten thoroughly and soundly by the Rockets of Houston. They came to town looking for a split. The split gets them the home court advantage.
Returning home, the Rockets played at fever pitch as they ferociously attack the stunned Lakers.
Oh, hey, a dunk by Olajuwon.
Into Kareem. Blocked by Olajuwon. Here's the fast break for the Rockets. Olajuwon. Triple on Akeem. Akeem with the basket and the foul.
You can see it in their eyes that they're panicked because they see that these guys are coming. No, these can beat us. They realized that we can lose this series. When you saw that weakness, then we gained confidence.
Grabbing games 3 and 4 in impressive style, the Rockets pushed the Lakers to the brink of elimination.
And the defending world champions have nowhere to go. The Houston Rockets going to be one game away from getting to the NBA Finals.
They're starting to believe in themselves. They're not taking anything for granted anymore. They are a team that has a possibility of winning a world championship, and they feel that.
All that was left was for Hakeem and the Rockets to complete the job. And they did, with one of playoff history's most dramatic finishes.
1 second on the clock. Sampson. Off balance has given the Houston Rockets the Western Conference Championship.
Unfortunately for the Rockets, their celebration would end one series too soon.
Reverse layup by Larry Bird, who has every move in the book. Celtic basketball.
Facing one of the greatest front lines of all time, Hakeem would play valiantly.
And there's another turnaround and another Hakeem Olajuwon foray.
But the veteran Celtics would prove to be too much. The championship would be theirs, but the future seemed destined to belong to Hakeem and the young Rockets.
Next year, we're going to do it, and we are still unbeatable.
Entering the 1986-87 season, the Rockets' expectations couldn't have been higher, especially those of Hakeem.
Playing against Boston was an experience for us that this was truly a championship team. And when they beat us, they show the experience and the superiority that they were supposed to win. So saying to myself, well, okay, just like college, we go back next year.
But Hakeem's high hopes were brought crashing down to earth as Houston lost three starters, including Ralph Sampson, to off-court problems and injuries, leaving Hakeem alone to shoulder the team's fortunes.
Olajuwon steals it. He'll win the race. He'll win the race. It's Navajo for two.
McRae gets a step.
Hakeem was named first team All-NBA and led the Rockets back into the postseason with their sights set on the finals.
Hakeem Olajuwon.
That was a man who was bound and determined that he was going to make sure we went. Hey, I'm going to do whatever I got to do to see that we do not lose because I want to go back. And that's the only thing that would have made the season complete in 86-87.
Facing the heavily favored Portland Trailblazers in the first round, Hakeem would again take it upon himself to carry his team.
Oh, he's everywhere.
An unbelievable performance. The Houston Rockets will move on to the semifinals of the Western Conference.
In the next round, the Seattle Supersonics looked to overwhelm Houston with their deep offensive arsenal. And at first, that's exactly what they did.
Final seconds. Chambers gets the basket at the buzzer.
And the Rockets are in trouble.
Facing elimination in Game 6 in Seattle, the Rockets turned to Hakeem for another heroic performance.
And Elijah Wan not yet ready to go on vacation. Hakeem is doubled. And he scores and gets the foul.
During a timeout, Dream will come and say, Bobby, I'm open, give me the ball. I say, well, Dream, you got four other guys hanging on you. That's okay, I dunk on all of them.
Hakeem goes strong to the basket.
We was triple teaming every time. And he was just unstoppable that night.
Hakeem Olajuwon has scored his team's last 12 points. He has been the king of this game.
Playing his best game as a pro, Hakeem would valiantly battle the Supersonics through two overtimes.
Tough shot. Hakeem has scored 7 points in the second overtime and has 49 in the game.
But even Hakeem's remarkable effort was not enough. As Seattle put a dramatic end to his hopes of returning to the finals.
The Sonics win a classic in double overtime over the Houston Rockets.
And worse, Hakeem's disappointment was only a prelude of what was to come. Just 19 games into the next season, the Twin Towers would be dismantled for good as Sampson was traded. And Hakeem was left behind to face a constantly shifting cast of teammates and a string of bitter first-round playoff disappointments.
The Dallas Mavericks sweep the Rockets here at the Summit.
At the buzzer, it counts, and Seattle wins and goes on to play in the second round. I can't believe it.
After a while, just playing for the season, knowing that we can win a championship, but it'll be a long shot.
He went through some tough times, the downfall of the Rockets after the 87 season. The team started to go south. He had to take the pressures of holding the franchise up almost by himself.
I think the loss of his teammates and the loss of great expectations because of that, I think, had an effect on him. But being the competitor he was, I think his individual game, he took it up to another level as many times as he could.
But as Houston continued to lose, Hakeem's brilliant individual performances no longer brought only praise.
His offensive game had come along so well that he could actually take on a double or triple team and have a better chance to score than passing the ball to an open man. So he got the label, and it was really a bum rap, that he was a selfish player, when in fact he was just showing the consummate competitor that he was.
And the harder Hakeem tried to reverse the Rockets' fortunes, the worse his plight became.
Nationally, he got this image of somebody who was never going to be able to be pleased by his teammates. In Houston, people who saw him play every night knew that this was a guy who was working his tail off and was doing everything he could to win.
Hakeem's woes deepened as his nightly pounding led to a list of debilitating injuries, one of which, a pulled hamstring, would cause a confrontation with Houston owner Charlie Thomas.
Hakeem the Dream says he can't play. He says he's injured. He says his hamstring hasn't healed. The Rockets say that's bull. They say he won't play because he wants his contract renegotiated. So today, the Rockets suspended Hakeem indefinitely without pay.
To openly question my integrity that I was faking injury, that was very shameful to me as a player and as a person.
As the 1991-92 season came to a close, it would see Hakeem miss the playoffs for the first time, and rumors of his departure spread through Houston.
Went in and talked to Charlie as a gentleman that the best thing is, like, let's dissolve this relationship in the best manner. You know, there's nothing personal. I was ready to play elsewhere. I was ready to go.
In the summer of 1992, Hakeem faced a crossroads. Each season, he had relentlessly improved his game. Yet for all his efforts, his team's fortunes had never been lower. A situation Hakeem found increasingly difficult to cope with.
I think he had found himself as a basketball player at that particular juncture of his career. But off the court, he hadn't really found himself in terms of how was he going to be successful as a basketball player and as a person.
Hakeem would search for solace by rededicating himself to his Islamic faith.
It changed everything, the whole outlook, you know, it changed everything. now is a state of mind. You know, you have trust in God. And you know, whatever He wills will happen. You know, so you believe in just doing the best you can. And once you've done the best you can, then that's, you leave it up to God to, you know, to decide, you know. If it's up to Him for me to win a championship, then it will happen.
I think Hakeem really, he developed a calmness in himself. I mean, once he got deep into his religion, he just got focused, and I think that really calmed him down as a person and as a player.
Hakeem's next step was to make amends with Rocket owner Charlie Thomas during a 14-hour flight to Japan.
This was the first time Charlie and I get the opportunity to open the line of communication to settle our differences. That made it up for everything to say, well, let's look forward. Forget about what you hear or what happened. Okay, let's move forward.
Hakeem was not the only one who had changed. His supporting cast had slowly been improving. And as he led them into the 1992-93 season, his spirits were higher than they'd been in years.
First of all, the individual talents, Kenny Smith, Maxwell, you know, we have Robert Horry, who is top. So now see myself now in the middle of all these talents. So give me a new energy.
Start working on coming.
Quick spin. Oh, man.
Rocket 13. Pass inside there. Oh, blocked by Elijah Wong.
Oh, boy. It's good to have him.
After years of carrying the Rockets, Hakeem now reveled in sharing the load.
I mean, the team, there's so much help from everybody, and they make my job so much easier. And I just, everything just pick up, you know, picks up automatically because the team are making it so much easier for me.
Herrera goes baseline, and off to Hakeem with a pass.
Dispelling any remaining notions that he was a selfish player, Hakeem helped the Rockets develop a new chemistry.
Now Elijah Wong being a point center.
Yeah.
He was very confident about his own ability and always has been, but he became much more confident about the people they put around him.
Elijah Wan saves it. Smith for three.
There's that ball movement by Elijah Wan that has become so potent for the Rockets this year.
He became a better passer, and he became a better student of the game. And by doing so, he made everybody around him, Otis Thorpe, Kenny Smith, Vernon Maxwell, all of these players became better players because Hakeem became a better player.
Back outside, Maxwell passes up the three-pointer, behind the back to Elijah Wan, back to Max. Max passes off to Hakeem! My goodness gracious!
And entering the postseason, the Rockets didn't miss a beat. Dispatching the LA Clippers, they tasted their first playoff success since 1987.
Elijah Wan, good save, good catch by Hakeem. Had to throw it over his back to Kenny Smith with a three. Right back to Hakeem. Hakeem is triple teamed. Robert Horry just beats the 24-second shot clock. Oh, baby! The Rockets are on their way!
And that is it for the Rockets and beat the Los Angeles Clippers.
I think the intensity and the unity that we, the way we came out this series, was very important. So I'm so proud of the guys, the way they played.
And in the second round, they would extend the talent-laden Supersonics to seven games.
Look at Hakeem Olajuwon. He gets out. The punch steal all the way. Hakeem with a steal and the fast break.
Though the Rockets would ultimately lose in a hectic last-minute finish, this defeat was a far cry from the one they'd suffered 6 years before. This time, it would be a stepping stone toward good things to come.
I can recall very vividly when they lost Game 7 in overtime. They came in the locker room and Hakeem sort of had his head down for a little while, and he looked up and he said, "We go from here."
As the Rockets entered the 1993-94 season, Houston's hopes were as high as they'd ever been. And Hakeem made sure that no one was disappointed.
Now he goes inside. Look at the spin move. Oh, what a move by Elijah Wan.
Whoa, Hakeem! The Rockets win their 11th game in a row. Sensational game for that man. Hakeem Elijah Wan, 37 points. And the Houston Rockets going to a record of 15-0.
Hakeem had the Rockets in high gear from the start. and leading by example. He dominated on both ends of the court.
Hakeem was just amazing. Just watching him was an awesome experience for our team.
Do they love it or what?
I think he just had a quiet confidence about him. It sounds strange. He almost had a regal presence.
And he never let the Rockets lose their intensity as he led them to 58 wins and captured the game's highest individual honor along the way.
In the 93-94 season, he was the most dominant player that I have ever seen in the game of basketball.
I'm here representing millions and millions of basketball fans around the world to tell you that you've had a spectacular NBA career. You've led your team to its best season ever. You're a certain Hall of Famer, and you do it with an elegance and a grace that's spectacular. Congratulations on being the 1994 NBA Most Valuable Player.
And as the Rockets began their playoff odyssey, Hakeem was well aware of the stakes.
Well, it was a lot of pressure. The second best record in the league. We know we cannot lose in the first round. So we were scared.
But if the Rockets felt a twinge of nerves, Hakeem quickly calmed them.
Goes left, runs right into Elijah Wan, blocks it.
No matter what the Portland Trail Blazers tried, they were simply unable to stop Elijah Wan.
Trying to turn baseline. What a shot!
In Portland, you know, they had Chris Dudley guarding him, and he just couldn't do anything with him.
Elijah Wan falling.
Oh my goodness, what an awesome fall away jumper.
Junior was scoring like 37, and the bench was going crazy, and Chris would look over at us with frustration on his face, you know, and we would tell him, don't worry about it, Chris, you know, it's not your fault.
And the Houston Rockets advanced to round number two against...
All right, now you've got to switch gears, and Sunday the Phoenix Suns, is that correct?
Yes.
Can you talk to us about the Phoenix Suns?
Well, we match up with them very well. I'm pretty much confident with our team. We just have to refocus now playing on Sunday.
The defending Western Conference champion Phoenix Suns presented the Rockets' first big test of the playoffs. The series began in Houston, and Hakeem was intent on ferociously defending the Rockets' home court advantage.
Elijah Wan against Young Miller. Horry off the assist from Elijah Wan.
But stunningly, the Rockets would squander an 18-point lead and suffer a heartbreaking Game 1 loss, and Game 2 would be no different, as Houston again grabbed an early lead and inexplicably let it slip away.
There's the trap on Elijah Wan. Oh, he throws it away, looking for Maxwell. And the Suns suddenly have come to life. Absolutely.
We were beating them by 20 points, by 18 points, and we got careless because we get so comfortable so quick, and we thought this would be an easy game.
Rockets just cannot buy a basket. Kind of like a plague, you know, it just starts to take over the entire team. Cassell leaning inside, throws it up, missed it, and another rebound goes to Phoenix. Marley will pull up and shoot a three. Marley hands it, and it's a seven-point game. Unbelievable collapse here by Houston.
Their confidence has just been shattered.
Now KJ breaks loose, feeds it off to Barkley. Barkley far corner for three. Shoots him! And Houston must feel like the roof is coming in. Well, the biggest collapse in NBA playoff history tonight.
It was terrible. We had the lead. But going back to the locker room, still cannot understand or explain or justify how we lost that game. We know for sure that this was the golden opportunity, and we're blowing it.
But Hakeem's pain was just beginning, as the press labeled the Rockets chokers and an embarrassment to their city.
So we called the meeting, and everybody opened up that now the city, now the reporters are against us, the whole world is against us. So now we only have ourselves in this room. then we have to be honest with ourselves.
Akeem was just fantastic in getting to the crux of the situation. And his statements were, are we going to, you know, we ought to make the commitment now to do it, or be honest with ourselves and say we don't want it.
Game three in a best of seven series. The Suns up 2-0. The Brooms may be in evidence Sunday if they can win here today.
You know, I remember looking in our guy's eyes and looking in his eyes, and no one was in a panic situation.
And as usual, Hakeem made sure they felt at ease.
Oh, look at the spin move by Olajuwon.
Hakeem at the dotted line, bumps AC off and turns around and drops it down.
When in doubt, go to your MVP. And
nice pass to Hakeem.
Well, he feels it. He's come out on fire.
I think he was very confident. You could see it in him. And when you know, your captains and your leaders have that kind of feeling, it just spreads throughout the team.
And the Rockets dutifully followed their captain's lead.
Penetration. Maxwell, how about five? Five threes in a row. I've never seen it. And the Rockets are rumbling again in Phoenix.
Grabbing games three and four on the Suns' home court, the Rockets battled back into the series.
Olajuwon putting the cherry on the sundae.
I think the first two games we lost was a blessing in disguise, because now we have something going, this chemistry that we have now, we will try our best to maintain it. If we maintain it, we go all the way.
The teams would split the next two games, setting up a decisive seventh contest in Houston.
This was a second chance,
and you can see it in everybody's eyes that everybody's committed to do the job. So now I have to fulfill my part.
Hakeem would do his part and more as he took over the game from the start.
Oh, what a move. He wanted to take it right at Joe Klein. Fakes that baseline move, goes to the middle, leans in. Wow, how do you stop it? You just can't stop it.
Paul Westphal is ready to throw his hands up. There's nothing Green or anybody else on the Suns can do.
Delivering one of his finest clutch performances, Hakeem would make sure that the memories of Choke City would be all but erased.
Goes to KJ, and Olajuwon drops it into the fourth goal. Oh, baby.
Hakeem Olajuwon, 37 points, 17 rebounds, 3 blocked shots. Now to 10 seconds. Olajuwon gets that in count, and that will do it. The Houston Rockets on their way to the Western Conference Final.
What can you say about Hakeem? I mean, what can you say? The guy, he does it all. You know, I just feel privileged to coach somebody like that. I mean, that's just amazing.
The Western Conference Finals would almost be an afterthought. The Rockets were all business as they eliminated the Utah Jazz with merciless efficiency.
Can you remember 1986, the last time this team was in the finals? You're the only guy in here that might remember. What's going to be different now?
I hope to win it all these times. That would be a big difference.
The finals, however, promised to be a grueling test as Hakeem and the Rockets faced the New York Knicks, who featured a familiar adversary.
And it will be Hakeem Olajuwon and Patrick Ewing.
10 years ago, Ewing had dealt Olajuwon a crushing defeat in the NCAA Finals. Now he again stood between Hakeem and his cherished goal.
With Patrick, that would be a classic matchup. But I look at the opportunity for the city of Houston. In the history of this city, there's never been a team that won a championship, so there would be something so unique. And to be part of that team, it would be something so special.
And in game one, Hakeem took history into his own hands.
Beautiful move by Hakeem Olajuwon. Olajuwon has hit his first four shots. Olajuwon again going right at Ewing.
Well, this is the problem that you run into when you try to cover this man on a one-on-one situation. As Hakeem Olajuwon having his way with the New York front line right now.
Easily gets away from Ewing. Has been unstoppable.
Yeah, that's game. That's game right there. Yeah.
But while Houston celebrated Olajuwon's spectacular performance, the Knicks looked ahead to Game 2 and plotted their revenge. Determined not to let Olajuwon take over the game, they swarmed him on every play.
Olajuwon getting inside, and he is fouled.
Pat Riley wants his team to get back to being the New York Knicks, which means tough, physical, aggressive.
Hakeem Olajuwon facing double and triple teaming.
Grinding Houston's attack to a halt, the Knicks dealt the Rockets a demoralizing home court loss.
The dream has been devastated. The Knicks have smothered him inside. It's not been a factor.
And back in New York, they look to break their spirit.
Anthony Mason has been the Dream's worst nightmare.
Hakeem fought heroically, but the Knicks' relentless pressure took its toll as the Rockets lost two of the next three games.
Olajuwon is exhausted.
Once again, Hakeem Olajuwon not doing it in the fourth quarter. Olajuwon stripped. With the lead for Bonner. Yes, and it counts. This one is headed back to Houston with the Knicks up. 3-2. We're down.
One win away.
Tonight, Game 6, the 1994 NBA Finals. Rockets, the Dream, all backs to the wall.
Has come down to this for the Rockets. They must win at home tonight or spend the summer contemplating what might have been.
Well, a lot of pressure, but the pressure was on both teams because they didn't want to go to the final game. So that was the game that if they were going to win the championship, that was the game.
The Knicks counted on their suffocating defense to stop Hakeem one last time. But from the start, he responded with desperate determination.
To Sam Cassell. Sam, back door, Olajuwon slammed up!
For three quarters, Hakeem valiantly kept the Knicks at bay. But New York's inevitable run would finally come.
John starts with all eight Knick points to start the fourth quarter.
Shaking off fatigue, Hakeem dug in to weather the Knicks' barrage.
I'm going to run the fourth stop now.
Right down to Olajuwon, wheeling and dealing.
The rookie again is the championship on the line, and these two teams going at it.
No! No! No!
Pass to Mason. Tries to muscle in on the right side. Kicks it out back to Starks. Open for a three, and he scores! Yeah. John Starks, unconscious here, keeping the Knicks alive.
And with his season-long quest at stake, he would search for the strength to find one more heroic play.
86-84. Knicks now by two.
All right, here we go. 5.5 seconds to go. Now to Stark. Stark against Maxwell. Ewing sets the pick. Stark with a look from three. Tip, and it's knocked away. And the Rockets win. The ball was tipped.
Olajuwon, Joe. Olajuwon with the big tip.
Stark comes off open, and Hakeem sort of loses his balance, gathers himself. And I've seen him do it so many times before. I mean, there's just no way he's going to be denied. He's going to get the thing done.
The MVP saves the Houston Rockets, and there will be a Game 7.
Back in training camp, we set a goal, and that goal was to win the championship. And it's taken a hell of a lot of hard work, and it doesn't make sense to do all this work and come this far and not close it out.
We came to the locker room, you see the locker room was set up, ready to celebrate. I looked on TV, they showed the other locker room, also ready to celebrate.
But in his heart, Hakeem knew that it was finally his time to celebrate.
He realized how much we had overcome as a team and how much he had overcome individually, that he wouldn't let this chance slip away.
Shot clock at three. Here's Starks, rejected by Elijah Wall.
Spinning, baseline, puts up, Elijah Wall! Unbelievable!
And yes, the Rockets are fired up.
Since his first days at the University of Houston, Hakeem had labored to bring his city a championship. And now, in front of his devoted fans, he would complete his decade-long quest.
Tomahawk jams it home!
These are the moments, the championship moments that define the great players. The guys that are born to play basketball, the guys that are born to win.
Seeing him progress from coming to this country, straight from Nigeria, to the point where he is now, is great. Because I see a young man who worked his tail off and deserves everything that he has received.
Ajawan says, get out of here with that stuff.
You know, I just thought back to when he first got here, the years he had with us. I was just extremely proud for him and knew he deserved it. My golly, he deserved it.
And the Houston Rockets, led by Hakeem Olajuwon, are the world champions of 1994.
I think what sums it all up is him sitting there as the buzzer goes off and just absorbing all of this this wonderful feeling. I mean, just watching that gives me goosebumps.
An NBA championship for Houston.
They're bobbing themselves. How sweet it is.
It's an experience that you can't explain it. It was just something that's so overwhelming. You've been hearing about the championship so long. Now to actually realize it, that it's over, we've won it, is unbelievable.
Took him 10 years, but Hakeem finally has won the big one.
It was a dream that probably could have had two NCAA championship rings, but it was so close he didn't make it. It was a dream that could have had the ring and all of us the trophy in 86, and we felt that pain in the locker room in Boston. And I watched him, and when they won, I was so happy for Hakeem. But I'll be honest, I started crying.
A taxi cab deposited him on the steps of Hoffman's Pavilion back in 1980, and he took it from there. And what a rise to greatness for Hakeem Olajuwon. Gonna try it again. Yeah, he gets a third block. Lost it. Olajuwon over the shoulder. Kenny Smith has to save it. He does, and he leaves it up. Olajuwon and the foul. Kenny Smith quickly up to Robert Horry. Olajuwon behind the back.
The rebound. Cavs pressing the tempo. Randle with a great pass. Oh, what a block by Olajuwon.
Cassell.